Dear friends, this is episode number 17 of the Limitation Act. In one of the comments with respect to the video lecture on section 7, 8, 6, 7 and 8, one Siddharth Sharma had commented that the decision in Moidu Haji versus Kunya Abdullah, which I cited before you, Moidu Haji versus Kunya Abdullah, which I cited 1998 to KLT 691, that was overruled by the Supreme Court. Sri Sharma had also given me a link. I searched. It is not reported in the major journals. It is reported in HTTPS, Indian Canon 1290397. I searched and found out. There, the Kerala High Court decision was reversed on some other point, but this point which was conveyed to you on the basis of section 6, 7 and 8 was not touched is what I understood. But anyhow, let us forget about that decision, but there are other decisions of the Supreme Court and also the decision of the Kerala High Court which I cited, which will cover the subject. Anyhow, Mr. Sharma, thank you very much. Now we will go to section 10. Section 10, suits against trustees and their representatives. Notwithstanding anything contained in the foregoing provisions of this act, no suit against a person in whom the property has become vested in trust for any specific purpose, or against his legal representatives or assigns, not being assigns for valuable consideration, for the purpose of following in his or their hands such property, or the proceeds thereof, or for an account of such property or proceeds, shall be barred by any length of time. So what is this? Notwithstanding anything contained in the foregoing provisions. So all these in the foregoing provisions till then, that will not apply. Notwithstanding anything contained. No suit against a person in whom the property has become vested in trust for a specific purpose. So there must be a vesting in a trust, and it must be for a specific purpose. Any person vested in trust for a specific purpose or against his legal representatives. Exception, assigns for valuable consideration. For the purpose of following in his or their hands such property or the proceeds thereof, shall be barred by any length of time. So there is, what is trust? Trust is a relationship, a fiduciary relationship, mutual trust and confidence. And the trustee is bound to account to the Sestwiki Trust, who are the beneficiaries. And that liability will not end by the flux of time. Because of the position he is holding, he is bound to account. And even if it is converted into cash or any other thing, the beneficiaries who are filing a suit can proceed against the proceeds. Not only the property, which is vested in trust, but if it is converted, if it is disposed of, it can be proceeded. The proceeds also can be proceeded with. it is not barred by any length of time. That is the meaning of section 10. Explanation. For the purpose of this section, any property comprised in a Hindu, Muslim or Buddhist, religious or charitable endowment shall be deemed to be property vested in trust for a specific purpose, and the manager of the property shall be deemed to be trustees thereof. Major items of the trust properties are dealt with by these organizations, religious organizations, and such trusts are, they are liable to account any beneficiary. Beneficiaries are sometimes large number of persons, devotees of a temple or members of a waqf, beneficiaries of a waqf, beneficiaries of a church. All these people are beneficiaries. They are entitled to challenge the action of the trustee. If there is a public trust, we have seen section 92 CPC, removal of trustee and all those things. This is there, this is not barred by any length of time. Any length of time. So it can be proceeded with at any time. No period of limitation. And naturally, because of this, several litigations arise where this point is being raised. And apart from these Hindu religious and charitable endowments and other trusts for a specific purpose, there is no confusion. It is a trust for a specific purpose. We can understand from the nature of the creation of the trust, the document of trust, and other objects which are sought to be achieved by the formation of the trust and all those things, it will be clear whether it is vested in trust for a specific purpose. There are some other transactions, some other relationships, which though not specifically, it can be seen as the relationship of trust for a specific purpose. But there are certain relationships which can be termed as trust for indirectly, at least for specific purposes, which I will mention hereafter. And several litigations are there. At least in our state, the major item of this application of section 10 is on marital disputes, matrimonial disputes, which I will say how it arises. Dowry is there, which is called Stridharam. Stridharam in the say Hindu law parlance, pristine law, Hindu law parlance, is the property acquired by a female out of her own labor, or given at the time of marriage, or anything which she has acquired, that is what is called Stridharam. There is a specific provision for inheritance which is different from the other things. That is really Stridharam. But what we call in our state, at least, Stridharam is dowry. Dowry is rampant, at least in some parts of the state. No doubt about it. I am sure that in other parts of the states, except some pockets, dowry is there. Dowry Prohibition Act is there. It is made punishable. Apart from that, the statute, it cannot be effectively prevented because of the particular relationships, particular situations in the parties are placed, particularly the females. And therefore it becomes, see, that culture is to be changed. Otherwise, because of any law, nobody is going to change. In some form or other, dowry will be received as gift or something like that. But often disputes arise when the relationship of husband and wife is broken, and some case arises. All these things will arise. At the time of marriage, the girl's husband, a girl's father had given to the boy's husband. The girl's father had given to the boy or his father considerable amount cash, ornaments, other items, car. See, in our state at least that is in terms of 100 sovereigns, 200 sovereigns, say BMW car, Benz car, this car and all those things. See, the marriage may, the relationship may become strained after 10 years, 12 years, 15 years. Then by that time the money is misappropriated by the husband and his family members. How to recover it? 3 years over, 10 years, 12 years, everything over. So limitation will be pleaded. How to face it? There are some decisions which say that this amount can be recovered by the wife's people, by the wife and her parents, if they are interested, by filing a suit for that purpose, and Section 10 will apply. I will give those citations. You go through it and various decisions I will give. One is 1993, and all these are Kerala decisions, probably because the litigation is here more, the amount involved is more, dowry is more rampant. 1993 2 KLT 798, Shosha versus Varghese. Please note, single bench, Justice Parith Pillai. Unpaid Sridharam, share claimed in the properties and contended that Section 10 of the Limitation Act applies to. Unpaid Sridharam amount will not have the character of a trust, and hence Section 10 of the Limitation Act cannot have any application. This is what is held. Implied trusts or obligations in the nature of trusts do not come within the purview of Section 10. This is what is held in that judgment. In view of Section 28 of the Travancore Christian Succession Act, the plaintiff can only seek enforcement of a charge on the property and cannot invoke Section 10 of the Limitation Act. This is what is held. In the Dowry Prohibition Act, there is a section, I think it is Section 6 or so, where within a particular time it is not paid to the girl, that is the wife, it is punishable. And till that time, a short period is provided. The husband or in-laws will hold it as trust. That section is there in none of these decisions that is referred to. But whether it is a permanent character, all those things, whether it continues even after that period, whether that relationship of trustee, beneficiary of the trust and trustee will continue, etc., there is no decision on that point. Now another decision, 1993 1 KLT 675, Chakko versus Annamma. There several decisions have been division bench. Please note Justice Varghese Kalyath and Justice Narayana Kurup, and several decisions were referred to. I will refer to those paragraphs and I'll read some of the portions also, because it is very, very informative. Yes, Chakko versus Annamma, Christians. Sridharam, when the father of the Christian girl pays Sridharam to her father-in-law, what happens? What is that relationship called? It was held that an express trust is created. Please read paragraph 24 onwards. There a decision AER 1972 Kerala 170. Annamma versus Thresiamma, a single bench. Justice Subramaniam Potti is referred to. Considered the question in regard to Sridharam and observed that payment of amount of Sridharam by the father of a girl to her father-in-law at the time of marriage is not intended to be trust for a specific purpose. Further observed that implied trusts or obligations in the nature of trusts are not within the scope of Section 10 of the Limitation Act. Then the division bench holds, we feel that the learned single judge has given undue importance to the term used, a trust for a specific purpose. As we said earlier, a trust for a specific purpose only denotes that it is an express trust. Further, it has to be noted that at the time when that decision was rendered, the marginal note of Section 10 of the Limitation Act contained the words express, which was omitted. Perhaps for the reason that the use of the words for specific purpose is only to distinguish the trust as an express trust. We are of opinion that particularly in a Christian marriage, when the father of the girl makes a payment, which has to be considered as sridhanam to her father-in-law, though not directly by specific words, but by the very act, certainly indirectly an express trust is created and the girl is made the sestuque trust, and in that context, there is nothing wrong in adopting a purposive interpretation of the content of Section 10 of the Limitation Act by holding that when such payment takes place, the money paid would constitute in the hands of the husband or father-in-law the subject matter of an express trust, and the amount is a trust property or trust money. I am reading this paragraph because of this importance. There are various views expressed by different benches. The context and circumstance behove and beseem the creation of an express trust. We are of opinion that it may not be very correct to say that the payment of money by the father to the girl or father-in-law or the husband would not constitute an express trust, though an open and direct declaration did not precede the payment. All these are done in a clandestine manner, not directly. This is, I am giving dowry. No, nobody will declare it. Then under Bill's law of trust and trustees referred to, trust are divided into two broad categories, simple trust and special trust. It is a very, very detailed judgment, all these things. It is difficult for us to agree with the observations contained in 72 Kerala 170 that Section 10 of the Limitation Act is not applicable. Then another decision was referred to in 1992 KLT 604, Swapna versus Thangavelu by Justice Krishnamurthy. Following the decisions in so-and-so 891 KLT, Maniamma versus Abdul Razak held that the husband is in a position of a trustee so far as the ornaments and utensils entrusted to him by the wife are concerned. And under Section 10 of the Indian Limitation Act, there shall not be any limitation for. Justice Krishnamurthy also held that. And it is noted by Justice Varghese Kalyath in this division bench which I mentioned, Chakko versus Annamma. But the learned judge has followed 85 Supreme Court 628 and 891 KLT 636. 85 Supreme Court 628, the learned judges were considering a question under Section 405 and 406 of the Indian Penal Code, breach of trust. In regard to sridhanam property of a wife, the Supreme Court found that all the ingredients of offences under Section 405 of the Indian Penal Code have been proved in the case. In majority judgment, Justice Fasil Ali, speaking for himself, and Sabyasachi Mukherjee J, observed that it cannot be said that upon a woman entering the matrimonial home, the ownership of sridhanam property becomes joint with her husband or his relations. Even those contentions were raised, and therefore there is no breach of trust. It was held by the Supreme Court that there is breach of trust. And Justice Katie Thomas followed it in 1989 1 KLT 636, Maniamma versus Abdul Razak. Maniamma versus Abdul Razak. these are the decisions on that point. Now, there is a Madras decision, AER 1991 Madras 90. It is reported in KHC also, 1991 KHC 2359. Name of the case, Papa versus Shanmugathammal and others. Papa versus Shanmugathammal and others. Suit for accounts in respect of a private trust. And the trust was created in favor of a third party in respect of suit for accounts. Section 10 will apply and the suit could not be said to be barred by limitation. Now some other decisions also I may refer to. So when you read Chakko versus Annamma, you will get majority of the decisions which were decided by the Kerala High Court. Then another division bench, 1993 KHC 555, Sudarsh, which is also reported in ILR 1993 3 Kerala 782, Sudarshan Chits India Limited versus Narasimholu Chetty and another, Madalam Narasimholu Chetty and another. Liquidator of a company carrying on chit transaction, he is not a trustee for its creditors. Section 10 does not apply. Then what is held in paragraph 2 is that even in case it is taken that the Companies Act imposes on the liquidator liability in the nature of trust and therefore a claimant is not precluded from claiming amounts due to him, it will not automatically follow that the same reasoning applies to the amount due from a creditor to the company. In order that Section 10 of the Limitation Act may apply, the property must become vested in trust for a specific purpose. Chit fund is a mutual recurring deposit scheme under which every member is entitled to receive the priced amount as loan from the chit fund, etc., etc. It is a full bench decision of the Kerala High Court in 1983 KLT 197. Janardhana Mallan versus Gangadharan, 1983 KLT 197 was also considered by the division bench. Then there is another decision, 2003 1 KLT 571, which is also reported in 2003 KHC 128, that was by Justice R. Bhaskaran. Rajan Nair versus Balakrishnan Nair. What is held is that the learned counsel for the appellant put forward three contentions in support of the appeal. The first is that the first defendant is in the position of a trustee being a partner of the firm, and by virtue of Section 10 of the Limitation Act, there is no limitation applicable for filing the suit. This is the contention which is put forward. The parties are partners. I do not think that it is possible to accept the above contention. Since Section 10 specifically states that no suit against a person in whom the property has become vested in trust for any specific purpose shall be barred by any length of time. And he is not a trustee because the first defendant is only a partner of the firm. That will not apply is what is held in Rajan Nair's case. Then please see a division bench, 2011 1 KHC 438, GK Engineering Works versus Messrs. സെയിൻറ്റ് ജോൺ ദ ബാപ്റ്റിസ്റ്റ് ട്രസ്റ്റ് ആലുവ, സെയിൻറ്റ് ജോൺസ് ദ ബാപ്റ്റിസ്റ്റ് ട്രസ്റ്റ്. ദ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഓഫ് സെക്ഷൻ 10 വാസ് കൺസിഡർഡ്. വിൽ ഡിസ്കസ് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻ ദി നെക്സ്റ്റ് എപ്പിസോഡ്. താങ്ക് യു.